So, hi, good evening. Do I have audio? I guess so.
Yes.
Super, thank you. So, I am Alberto Planas. And
Hello.
Hello. So, I am Alberto Planas. I'm part of the OpenSUSE community, but also I am a SUSE employee, part of a very cool team that is under the name Future Technology Team, something that I really love the name. And we basically do crazy stuff. So we have a lot of freedom to experiment and to provide solutions or provide alternative solutions to new problems and play with them. So today I'm going to present one of those experiments. Actually, it's an experiment with a background behind that is OBS Git. That is some kind of a bridge between the world of OBS, our build system, and the Git source control management tool that we all use and love. So let me, we have a tour here and a small agenda. So let's talk about the background. So we have a client. This client is trying to do an operating system based on SLE. It's a super cool project. If you have the slide, click in this car was blue text. You are going to go to an article that is going to describe the project. It's super nice. But basically, again, this is a very minimal, a very small distribution based on SLE. And we have several teams that we need to work together, part of SUSE, part of this company, and a third component. We need to work together, and we need to use OBS. Of course, we need to use the build system. We need to use OpenQA. We need to use the staging projects and all the different tools that are completely validated in our workflow during the creation of the operating system. They work. They are excellent. We need to use that. But we have a problem. So the problem is that this is also a cooperation work. It's, we need to cooperate in the development of this distribution. And we have different build services that they can't talk with each other. This is not a technical problem. OBS, of course, supports this feature. But there is some certification behind that that completely forbid the connectivity between the different build services. And still, we need to work together. There is also, during the discussion, we discovered that there is something that we really need, that is this single representation of the project. So you know that when you are working with a package in OBS, you can see in the history all the different change that you have, and you can go back to any other old version. You can recover this version and test and make fixes from there. You can also make forks from old versions. So in the package level, everything was okay. But if you move to the project level, so this conglomerate of different package, you are going to find problems in selecting one point of time where all the package and all the metadata match with a single point. This is also, if you know Git, this is something that is completely trivial and is for free in Git. You have this SHA hash that completely represent the full description of the project, All the files, the blobs, the metadata, permissions, everything is there. And this is something that we know for a long time ago that is really critical and really important when you are working with QA. So you want to test a specific configuration of your project and go back if something goes wrong for the full project and not for a subset of the project. But anyway, this project is new and is the perfect alibi to make an experiment. That is, how much can we go in moving the development of the operating system from OBS into Git? So let's see. We need to start small. So this is a small project, but also have some time constraint. So something that was obviously is that we need to start with something very basic. The core idea is that we need to separate the build process from the source management. So OBS is a really brilliant build service, but also have a lot of features related with the management of the source file, the source package. We want to use only OBS for the building aspect. So OBS is going to take care of the create repositories, to define the product, definition of the compose of the package that is going to belong there, the creating RPN and make create syncs of these RPNs to make sure that come from the correct build service. Everything that is related to the building of the operating system is going to be part of the of OBS. But the management of the source file, so the chain log, the spec file, the patches, everything that including the source tarball is going to belong to Git. So you are going to have one representation, the canonical one, is going to live in Git. And we are going to delegate in OBS the building of the operating system, the package, and the project itself. So the what is the minimal feature that we need to implement to have this these characteristics there? So we are going to build a small tool that is going to export a full project from OBS to Git, and a tool, or the same tool, that is going to go back from Git to OBS. So this is the basic idea, and the main problem is about what happened with the tarballs, with those massive big files that contain the source of the package, and usually it's a binary format. So we have different backends implemented. One is using the Git large file storage. It's a very well and supported protocol for a big file that is implemented in GitLab and GitHub, super fast, super reliable. But it's a bit problematic to work in OBS because you need to download and upload every time. We have also OBS. With OBS, you can implement something that can become something very similar to an storage. There are some limitations because OBS doesn't provide an API for that, but we have a backend for that. And you can extend this model with IPFS or other backend model. So this is the current way of working, OLC and OBS, and this is the new proposal. So everything is going to be in Git, one single canonical representation in GitHub or GitLab with a different protocol of communication, and you can use OLC and OLC for example, for making a small test or a small build, and OBS is the server that is going to create the RPNs for you. So how is the user experience for that? So it's something like that. So you're going to have OLC Git export, the name of the project, and for you, it's going to detect if you have LFS active, and if that is going to use that, it's going to create asynchronous, it's going to create a Git repository for you in your local system that represent the source file that are living in the build system. And you can inspect this, now you have access to Git, you are now living in the Git world. Because you are using LFS, you have these Git attributes that you need to address. The exporter is taking care for you to detecting the binary files and registering that for you, but you can make adjustments. It's completely free for you to make those adjustments. You can add those packages. There is some metadata file that is living in this .obs files. There's one metadata for the project and one metadata for each one of the package. You are completely free from now to edit that, make adjustments, or simply ignore those metadata files. And you can start doing the commit from this point. It's going to be very easy. You can edit the file, do commits, do rebase, share patches via email, or create merge requests into a GitLab or GitHub instance. Now it's completely 100% Git problem. You can start having the slash service there. So everything is completely normal. You can replace the binary file, you can edit the chain file, so whatever. Everything is completely free for doing that. But from time to time, you want to build the project. You can have, now you are going to set your workflow. You can have, in OBS, you can have, on your build system, you can have a project that is going to be the canonical representation of your build system, but you can create your own copies of this project using the import command. With the import command, if the project doesn't exist, it's going to populate the metadata to create one from scratch using the metadata with a small modification, a small adjustment that OBS Git is going to do for you. It's going to publish all the binaries and build all the full project. You can now it's living in OBS, but still the canonical representation is the one that you have in the Git repository. It's not the one that you create a copy. You can have multiple copies, and only one of them, the one that you decide, is going to be the product or the operating system or the package that is for you, the one that you want to distribute to your clients or users. Something to say about that. I think that I was very clear. So this is a very minimal version of SLE. It's like two orders of magnitude smaller than SLE, than Tumbleweed, sorry. Tumbleweed is massive, it's really, really big. And the question here is, can we use some of the ideas that we learned with this experiment and escalate that in something as big as Tumbleweed? My opinion is that we can. Definitely we can, and we must to do that. In my opinion, Git is a really pleasure to use. It's using the semantic that we are completely used to when in our daily work. So the concept of a chain set, the concept of a commit, the concept of a rebase, the representation of your full project in a single hash, all this kind of mental model is very useful for the daily work in the management of the operating system or the package management. But we need change. So this the OBS Git is not good for this something so big as a factory, but we can make change to make it possible. One possible change that we can use is move from a specific tool to some plugin based on in Git. So something like Git OBS, and you now have a single command line to address the Git side and the OBS side. Because OSC is writing in Python, and we have the prototype of OBS Git is also in Python. Technically, we can import in our code the OSC libraries. We need some refactoring OSC, but it's possible to have all the features that we use in OSC inside Git. So we can build locally the package that we have in Git and experience the Git side and the OBS side in a same command line. Another problem is that if we want to use OBS as a storage and we want a fast user experience, it's fast today, but we want something really, really fast and take advantage of this caching system that OBS have today, we need a different API. We need to make some change in the core of OBS, in the external API, in order to export a single tarball from one project to another, instead of exporting or copying the full project, only a subset of this project. With this single API, we can have a much better experience. Another question that we need to do to answer is that we want, when we create the first export, no, we want to maintain the full history as a representation of different commits in Git. This is what can be yes, and that means a lot of work. And the big problem is the monorepo question. So OBS Git is using monorepo, but in my opinion, something as big as a factory, a different alternative is need to be explored. So we have a sub-project, and we have these sub-modules as sub-trees. I play a bit with them. I think that one of those can be very helpful for the representation of what is a devel project or the concept of a devel project that we use today. We need to change this concept. We need to adapt the concept that we have in OBS to make some change to match with Git, but it's possible to do. And there are all details you set for different products where the underscore link is reused for different tasks, but I'm sure that there are a lot of hidden features, small features that are exploded in OBS for products that are not, maybe they're not super trivial to map into Git. Wow, that was fast. And done. So the basic idea, this is something that I plan to work on. So this is this list of problems is something that I want to work on. And if you want to help me, please, in the first slide, I have my email, but you can reach me in the SUSE, in the factory mailing list and in the project mailing list. Ping me and we can discuss the next step. or you can fork the project and we can, so the project is in GitHub, in my account, and fork that and we can work together. And that was all. Thank you.
Would you be around in the conference like hallway chat thing after this?
I need to leave. It's super late here, and I need to leave. But I am in the mailing list, and now I need to leave because the next one needs to start. Thank you again, and let's talk in the mailing list.